Niedermeyer at the front. He got it. And a shot. He scores! Scott Niedermeyer. The Devils win in overtime. And that one went wide. Rebound. Score! Randy McKay with his fourth goal of the game. Kovalchuk goes to work on a pair. Shooting. Moves on in, backhander score! Zach Parise with his 100th career goal. Oh, Willis was freight train hit by Stevens. Oh, and a healthy hit by Ken Danico on Recchi.
The championship to New Jersey. The Devils win the Stanley Cup.
Devils fans, please welcome our MC for tonight's ceremony, the radio voice of your New Jersey Devils, Matt Laughlin.
Thank you, and good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Devils fans everywhere. Tonight, the Devils honor a man whose career stats show no goals scored, no saves made, and not 1 minute spent in the penalty box. But for 21 seasons, he was as important a member of the Devils family as anyone who ever wore the Devils sweater. Mike "Doc" Emrick's passion for the game, his incomparable use of the English language, and his rhythmic and lyrical play-by-play brought a nightly joy to those who tuned in to watch Devils hockey. And as you'll see in this video presentation, it was a meeting long ago that brought Doc here with us tonight.
In the early years, there was the only guy that I really knew growing up was Bob Chase, who, thank God, still works in Fort Wayne, Indiana. This is his 59th year with the Fort Wayne Comets. He has spoken to more people on a 50,000-watt radio station about hockey than anyone in the United States. He was the guy that you always con a professor into allowing you to do a term paper on something, and then you use people like Bob Chase at a prominent station. You call and say, hey, I'm a student at Manchester College. I'm doing a term paper on sports broadcasting. Would you have a few moments?
He came into a building one day and said who he was, and he'd been listening to me, and he'd seen a game. And he wondered what it would take for him to possibly try to become a hockey announcer. And I said, well, the one thing you have to do is practice, practice. And I said, the most important thing, regardless of where you go or what you do, if you're in the broadcast business, be yourself.
I caught on with Sports Channel before it was amalgamated into the MSG Network family. When I first came here, the network that I worked for wanted us to be objective. And Lou Lamorello told me on the phone when I was standing somewhat nervously in Petoskey, Michigan on the phone with him at the time, you never forget where you are when you hear important things. He said, you're not good to us if you can't be believed.
Here is Zajac, long toss. Parise is in all alone for the win. Score!
Oh, Doc, this is incredible.
I think of all those times sitting up in the booth, you down on the ice, honoring one of the great Devils, whether it was a sweater retirement, whether it was reaching a milestone, and a bunch of other times that you were down on the ice, paying tribute to someone who really deserved it.
Chico is a great soul, and I think God put Chico in my path because there were so many wonderful years that we spent together. And I think we shared an awful lot of each other's lives during that time.
The championship to New Jersey. The Devils win the Stanley Cup.
In the final minute, John wanted to, as he always does, at the end of a series, pay tribute to both teams, including Detroit, and say what they had done that was so wonderful during the season. And the only thing I said to him was, if I can have 5 seconds at the end. And of course, John was out with 6 seconds to go. That's how his timing was. And that enabled me to get in the last bit about the championship to New Jersey. The Devils win the Stanley Cup. That meant a lot to me, and I think it meant a lot to people in New Jersey, because this was New Jersey's team. It was metropolitan area of New York, but it was New Jersey's team. They won a Stanley Cup, and there'd never been anything like that here. So that was important to me. Lou called Joyce and I this summer. We happened to be in Chicago at the time the call came, and of course by that time, you know, our path had pretty well been chosen, and it impressed us as a chance to finally get an opportunity to say thanks to everybody all in one place. So I would say thank you for your support of me and for your tenacity in hanging in there during the bad years and now relishing some of the good years. There may be those in the future, but we sure can dwell on the past and have big smiles on our faces.
As the Devils family honors one of its own, it is entirely proper and fitting that members of Doc's immediate family are here tonight to celebrate along with him. Please welcome to Prudential Center his nephew, Ryan Sult, his stepmother, Mary, his brother, Dan, and his lovely bride of 33 years, Joyce. Some say it's a long way to anywhere from LaFountain, Indiana, the small town where Doc grew up. But from that Midwestern locale, Doc scaled broadcasting's highest heights. In 2004, he was awarded the Lester Patrick Trophy for his outstanding service to hockey in the United States. In 2008, he was presented the Foster Hewitt Memorial Award for Broadcasting Excellence by the Hockey Hall of Fame. And recently, in December of last year, he became the first broadcaster to be inducted into the United States Hockey Hall of Fame. Yes, he belongs to the hockey world, but for 21 seasons, he was our guy. Devils fans, please welcome back Doc Emrick. The people and organizations for whom Doc meant so much during his career are here this evening to present some gifts to Doc as an expression of their appreciation. Representing Madison Square Garden Network is his broadcasting partner, longtime analyst, and former Devils goalie, Glenn Chico Resch. Doc, your former colleagues at MSG Network are sending you and Joyce on a week's vacation at the famed Grand Hotel on Mackinac Island in Michigan. Representing every Devils player who ever had his name announced or his story told by Doc is Devils captain Zach Parise, here to present Doc with a watch. Also on hand this evening is New Jersey Devils chairman and managing partner Jeff Vanderbeek to present two gifts. The first is a specially designed framed Doc number one Devils jersey. And the second has just pulled up behind us in the Zamboni entrance, a 2012 all-wheel drive, fully loaded black Lincoln MKZ. For many years, I had the privilege to work with Doc and the entire MSG network crew. A part of my job as the pregame and intermission host was to do what we call in the business a toss. After welcoming our viewers to the broadcast, I would toss it to Doc and Chico, and they would tell us who and what to watch for in that particular game. Well, tonight, I get that privilege one more time, and it is with great pleasure that I toss it over to tonight's honoree, Doc Emrick.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This is a long-awaited chance that we have to say thank you for how kind you've been and what an honor it was to be one of your announcers for 21 seasons. Please don't misinterpret the brevity of these remarks for insincerity, but we have two outstanding teams. The one you support and the visitors have both won 8 of their last 10 games with one extra time loss and one regulation loss. They are both hot, and I'm anxious to see them play a hockey game. First of all, three names that you probably don't know, but they wear jerseys. Bob Smith wears number one, the best popcorn man you'll ever find at Newark Penn Station. He is a fan. Justin Grossman is only 14 years of age. He plays center for the New Jersey Stars. Tonight he's wearing another center's number, number 19. He is a fan. And Andy Gilchrist, longtime member of the Devils fan club, wears a jersey that has ZZ Pops on the back. He is the guy who gave Chico and I the name for Zach, Zajac, and Langenbrunner, to which Jamie said, great, 31 years old, and I'm Pops. To these three, and 19 million of the rest of you who have paid the price of admission to watch this team, thank you. Here are three more names that you may not know. Joe Cohen in 1983, through Jerry Pissarro, who hired me, through Dan Ronayne now. They ran the network that gave me a job, but they also gave you something. What they gave you was not just half the games on television, but for so many years, every last game is televised by someone. Now some names that you know. Chico and Steve and Deb, Matt and the Maven, our leader Roland Dratch out in the truck, They have shown you not only this wonderful hockey team, but in occasional intermissions, Chico Eats and Chuck the Duck. And now the names you know. I've had many memories, and this is the one I chose. May 2000, Conference Final, Devils Flyers. I never got a chance to say thank you, but tonight is the night. To Larry Robinson, the team down 3-1, for his inspirational speech after game 4. To Scott Stevens, for having the best game I ever saw a defenseman have in game 7. To Patrick Elias for the tie-breaking goal in game 7. To Marty Brodeur for the saves both before and after the tie-breaking goal. And to the staff inside and outside the athletic department that over that year and all the years before and after have been led to success by Lou Lamoriello. We were not club employees, but Dr. McMullen and Yankees Nets, and now Mr. Vanderbeek and his associates, have presented us with a lot of gifts, and 2 of them I have passed on. My nephew Ryan saw his first Devils game at age 12 wearing an Albany River Rats jersey. He now wears the 1995 Stanley Cup championship ring. My brother Dan, who was my first broadcast partner, we played softball and baseball in the yard. When he was 11, I was 8. Whoever was at bat broadcast the game. He wears the 2000 Stanley Cup ring. My wonderful stepmom, Mary. My father's best choice after an earlier best choice. My mom passed away. Both my parents have now passed. We have wonderful memories of both of them, but the memory I hold is of all the cards that you sent following each passing. They are for keeps. I still have them. Thank you. And when you battle cancer, you may have some sleepless hours, but you need a good soul to quietly stand by and keep both of you balanced in turbulent times. Under my new schedule, she tells me that I now know where all the light switches in the house finally are. But I am most thankful for my wife of 33 years, Joyce. And finally, as David Clarkson, Johan Hedberg, and Cam Jansen, and a number of the Devils will tell you, and as a number of the Canucks will tell you, there is nothing like being the owner of a dog. They are wonderful friends, and you can find one if you need a friend at a rescue shelter near you. That's the end of this commercial. This has been the best. I did not leave the best behind. The honor of doing your games is what I've had to take with me. Memories of this team, all of you, and this night. Thank you, Devils. Thank you, Canucks. Let's play hockey. God bless all of you.
Thank you, Doc. On behalf of Devils fans everywhere, thanks for the memories. We wish you continued success at NBC Sports and hope that one day soon we might hear you say on NBC, once again, the championship to New Jersey, and the Devils win the Stanley Cup.
Honoring Mike Doc Emrick, the longtime voice of the New Jersey Devils. When we come back, more reflections of Doc, and we're moments away from game time. The Devils and the Western Conference champion Canucks coming up next.